So it's that time of year again. It's Oscars time, this time brought to you over Microsoft Teams. Now, there is a definite trend towards certain cameras and certain lenses in the Oscar nominations this year. And if you want to read more about this, YM Cinema Magazine is a good place to go for an overview of which cameras they've used and which lenses they've used for the nominated films. And what's interesting this year is not so much the cameras. In fact, the cameras kind of not that interesting every year, because every year, every film uses an Arri Alexa. And although there are other cameras available, like the ones from Red, Sony, Canon, Panasonic, Panavision, they only occasionally crop up in the Oscar-nominated pictures, and the vast majority is an Arri Alexa or an Alexa Mini LF with the large format full-frame sensor. But this year it is interesting to look at what lenses have been used, because there is a definite tendency and a trend towards more vintage lenses, especially vintage anamorphic lenses, and the beautiful old Panavision LOMO Russian anamorphics. But also, I really like the trend for filmmakers to use Canon K series vintage cinema lenses, because they are beautiful. And the magic thing about those is they're actually quite attainable in the form of Canon FD lenses. Now, we have a very rare gem here. This is the 135mm, nearly chopped my fingers off, eh? 135mm f2 Canon FD lens. Now, these are getting rarer and rarer on eBay, because film studios are snapping them up and turning them into cinema lenses, rehousing them, just taking the beautiful compact optics out and just putting them in a more robust housing to rent out and to use on film productions. But they really are, they're optically just superb, beautiful rendering, beautiful contrast and flare, and just a lovely kind of high resolution and yet forgiving softness, wide open yet detailed high resolution. It's exactly what filmmakers are looking for, so I'm not surprised that a lot of vintage lenses such as these are turning up in Oscar nominated pictures. However, as more and more professionals get their hands on these kind of lenses, the more and more the price goes up on eBay, and I just wish there was a way to find 40% off and then take another 25% off.
Always 40% off. You can add that 25% on top of that to get a huge discount.
They don't have to be living to be in love, okay? So he took these pictures and...
If only there was a way for the silver-haired clickweasel to make some affiliate link money from these vintage anamorphic lenses, then it'd be all over them, wouldn't he? But the promising thing here is that we truly live in the democratic age of filmmaking, where the rusty old LOMO anamorphic that you found from a seller in Moscow on eBay is now being used by Netflix on a multi-billion dollar production. So I'm definitely going to dust off my Russian anamorphic, and I'm also going to get a second. So let's just check eBay and see what prices the round fronts are going for, shall we? Another successful search. I can only find one, and it's broken, and it's $11,000. I don't think I'll be getting one of those anytime soon, and I better not drop the one I've already got. But anyway, let's have a look at Netflix then, and let's see the trailer for their Oscar-nominated film Passing. Because I just love to see that widescreen cinematic cinemascope anamorphic look.
Pardon me, I don't mean to stare, but I think I know you.
Claire?
Mm-hmm.
I'm trying to find out the history of the blonde you've brought along.
She's a girl from Chicago I used to know.
Princess from Chicago.
Things aren't always what they seem.
I'll be damned. Lots of people pass all the time.
It's easy for a Negro to pass for white. I'm not sure it'd be so simple for a white person to pass for color.
So you haven't ever thought to?
What?
You ever thought of passing?
No, why should I? Now I have everything I've ever wanted.
This is my husband, John Bellew. Does he know?
But you dislike Negroes, Mr. Bellew.
No, not at all.
Why is it square? Why Netflix?
This is really interesting, the technique of using a cinemascope widescreen anamorphic lens and then cropping it so much down to a 1950s television screen aspect ratio. So apparently this was shot on the Arri Alexa Mini and they cropped it so much in at the edges that you actually you came down to 1.7K. resolution. And we all know Netflix is quite strict about using 4K acquisition and very high resolution cameras, but it's great that they're taking creative risks like that, and I think it's a really interesting result. They've really nailed the vintage 1950s look, although actually the story is set in the 1920s. So but it works fantastically well. I'm really looking forward to seeing the film myself too. It still has that beautiful LOMO anamorphic look, even though they've cropped the heck out of it. Now, talking of vintage lenses, the Panavision C series goes back to 1968. It's not clear what Paul Thomas Anderson is using in his new film Licorice Pizza, whether it's the revitalised, re-engineered new versions, or whether he actually went back to use the old vintage 70s or 80s versions of the C-series lenses. But yeah, Licorice Pizza is another one on the Oscar noms list, which seems to have a beautiful vintage lens behind it. So let's take a look at the trailer for that one as well, because I've always admired Paul Thomas Anderson's films, especially There Will Be Blood and Magnolia. Absolutely fantastic. He's had a few misfires lately, but I'm hoping this is a return to form for him.
It's a god-awful small affair to the girl with the mousy hair.
I met the girl I'm gonna marry one day.
But her mummy is yelling no, and her daddy has told her to go.
Listen, young lady.
But her friend is nowhere to be seen.
So how'd you become such a hotshot actor?
I'm a showman. That's what I'm meant to do.
To the seats with the clearest view. Then she's hooked to the silver screen.
Do you know who I am?
Yeah.
Do you know who my girlfriend is?
Barbra Streisand?
Barbra Streisand.
Sand.
Sand, yeah, like sands. Like the ocean, like beaches.
Barbra Streisand?
No, like Streisand.
Sand.
But the film is a sad thing for.
This is fate that brought us together.
But she's lived it 10 times or more.
Our roads took us here.
She could spit in the eye.
You're not my director.
They ask her to focus
on. Do you really want to see my boobs?
Can I touch them?
See you tomorrow. I think it's weird to hang out with Gary and his friends all the time. I think it's weird that I hang out with Gary and his 15-year-old friends all the time.
Take a look at the old man, beating up the wrong guy. Oh man, wonder if you'll ever know.
I'm not gonna forget you.
Who's in the best-selling show?
Just like you're not gonna forget me. Gross.
Rosa! Roll camera A. Roll camera B. Parking.
Action.
And coming, Nancy!